Hey, it's Dr. Centeno, and I'd like to explain to you this morning why your shoulder surgeon likely has no idea how to use stem cells to help you avoid shoulder surgery. So we're starting to see surgeons offer stem cell and platelet treatments, and we certainly welcome them in this field. So for the most part, this is adding stem cells or platelet-rich plasma, which are the platelets from your own blood, into traditional surgery, kind of like magic pixie dust. Now, the research on this shows it doesn't work all that well, and I suspect that's because we need to get rid of the surgeries, not just add magic pixie dust into those surgeries. Because the real promise of regenerative medicine is to move patients away from invasive surgeries to minimally invasive, precise image-guided injections to promote healing, meaning that we won't be able to change the old ways of doing things by just doing them the same way. And we've seen some surgeons who've begun to inject stem cells or PRP, and we certainly welcome that, but they're doing it at this juncture more to prevent patients from leaving the practice to see non-surgeons offering interventional orthopedics. And there are a few big problems with inexpensive injections offered by surgeons. Number one, they don't have the training to use image guidance to perform true interventional orthopedics, and they have no incentive to make this stuff work. So what is interventional orthopedics and why is it so special? Well, we have simple injections on one side and we've got surgery on the other. And so when a surgeon does an injection in the shoulder of PRP or stem cells in the clinic or hires someone to do so, they're doing simple intra-articular put it in the joint type injections. Now that's very, very different than precisely placing the stuff exactly where it needs to be. As you can see there, there's all of those different targets that need to be hit to do this right, and that has to be under ultrasound or x-ray guidance or both. So just slapping it in the shoulder is not going to get you where you need to go. So what incentive does your surgeon have to learn this particular complex procedure to heal a type 2 slap tear? So this is a concrete example. This is an injection you're seeing there on the bottom where we're putting the stem cells directly into the type 2 slap tear. That's a very difficult procedure to learn how to do. It takes a long time to do it well. The answer is your surgeon has no incentive to do that because they're going to lose a surgical fee. They're going to lose the surgery center fee because almost all surgeons own surgery centers. And they're going to lose relationships with device manufacturers who make the anchors and surgical tools. So they have no incentive to learn this complex stuff. In addition, a non-surgeon working in a surgical practice generally can't tread there for all the same reasons. In conclusion, your surgeon learning interventional orthopedics is a massive financial conflict of interest. Hence, look for physicians who have been trained by the Interventional Orthopedics Foundation, who know how to do this complex work, and who know how to help you avoid shoulder surgery. Thanks so much and have a great day.